Clem will have to play, you know, Clem played 23 minutes last night, so he's got to play 30, 32, which he'll like. And, he needs to do that. And then the rest of it will be eaten up by PJ or both. We'll spread it out. He's an option if we, you know, if we need it. But right now, we'll stick with the guys that have been playing.
Mike, what did you say about you guys? You have two guys with 30 points, and none of them are James Harden, but just the depth on this team. And
yeah, and we probably had a couple other guys on the floor that could have been those guys too. So, yeah, they're just offensively. We've just got a lot of weapons, and we've got a lot of solutions to a lot of things, and we just got to keep getting better at what we do and keep our spirit. I thought the spirit last night was just terrific. There's always going to be mistakes offensively and defensively. But if we keep our spirit, keep playing, and keep going at people, we'll be good.
When you say spirit, can you put in words what Eric did? I mean, what he does on a regular basis.
Yeah, you know, just, you know, the thing I loved about it, because I took a chance. He had four fouls, I think. I forget how much time left in the third. It was the end of the third quarter. He had four fouls, and normally you would kind of take him out because without him and being shorthanded, but. Yeah, I just felt like it's too crucial part of the game, and he was able to, I think he was responsible for the next 9 points. And he was really good at making plays. And that's obviously invaluable. Somebody like that that can do that and have the presence of mind not to foul and the run the team is great.
What are the qualities that a guy like Ryan Anderson or PJ Tucker to be able to play at the five?
Well, Ryan's 6'10". He's not real small. I mean, he's taller and dark. You know, and Tuck, I think, is odd. It's just his strength. He's whatever. He's about, 6'2". So his strength is phenomenal. He plays hard. He knows how to use leverage. And Ryan does the same thing. They both guard five for a while. He said, I think he made a comment to somebody. He goes, well, you know, I thought I got fouled. I just threw it up. I got some mad. I saw that guy. He just went down. Good. I hope he gets mad more often.
Do you think he's been more aggressive over the course of the season, Eric? Not just with James out, especially taking him to the basket?
Yeah, his finishing's been phenomenal. And it's gotten better each year. And that's, you know, his working, doing extra work, and just his strength. Yeah, I think he's been really aggressive. I mean, his shots hasn't always been there this year, but he can always get to the basket and finishing great.
Do you think his physical strength is something that other teams still underestimate?
I guess, but you know, it's like you try to post him up, like, you know, posting up, you know, somebody that barrel chest. He puts his chest down, he's not going anywhere. He's really, really strong.
Who's my target?
I think he gets evaluated tomorrow. I mean, there's a chance. That's what they were saying last time. We haven't had the team today, so I don't know if it, you know, you got to keep it from getting affected. And it's a little bit of a process. I don't know if he can play with sunglasses on. He might be able to chill out a little bit.
Portland seemed pretty bent out of shape about the first of the layup late. It's a 9-point game. If there's anything to that. When he went to the basket, he said they weren't guarding him.
So it makes a big difference. I didn't even notice.
That's okay. I'll just do nothing to do on the night this morning.
No, he's not doing this trip. So
I asked us about fouls in that game. That's just because that game went off fouls. Recently, the players have spoken out about how they feel that there's some tension between them and refs. Now, players always have critiqued refs, wrestling, you know, whatever. They still say that this year it's different. Melo, in particular, said it's different than it was 15 years ago. Do you agree with that?
I don't know. You know, that's not. I'd be crossing the lines and say, I know. I don't know. It's always a highly competitive game, and there's always going to be viewpoints back and forth. And it's everybody has a tough job out there. Everybody. And everybody's under enormous pressure. And sometimes with a lot of pressure, pipes burst, and you know, so it happens. But legal, rein them back in, and players will rein themselves in, and officials and everybody else. And we're all in this together, and I'm sure, you know, we'll work it out.
What's the challenge that all the injuries that you have to make it all work? You're giving up a minutes, but your rotation has changed, you still have the same philosophy. How does that all work?
Well, the biggest thing that we we just got to be really careful and do the best we can and keep the minutes off guys. Like Chris had 32 last night, which is pretty good. You know, I could easily play in 36. But that's the challenge, is try to win that game and yet, you know, being able to sit guys and make sure they sit over there. But and try to figure out how to still play 7-8 guys and keep the minutes off.
In the heat of battle, are you thinking minutes?
Oh, yeah, no, it's always, especially with somebody like Chris. A little bit less other guys. Some guys can handle, like Trevor can handle it. I think about it, but, you know, if I have to give an extra 2 minutes, I'd rather give it to him because he handles it. But it's always a constant thing because you don't want to make a bad situation worse, but you also want to win. So you're just trying to balance it out.
Do you think that maybe easily players are speaking
up
this way now, has to be
the
generation of players, the generation
of
like
it's time. Jeez, you're getting so deep. I don't know. I'd have to sit down and think about it. I don't think about that. Actually, I just go home and watch Matlock or something. I try not to think about it. There's a lot of good reruns in my youth. I try to
watch. I think it's the sensitive millennials.
The what?
I think it's the sensitivity of millennials. That's my
opinion. Well, that seems to be a problem. We'll work on that.
You watch Bonanza and Gutsman up there?
Oh, yeah.
Really still, come on.
Yes, it does.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes, it does.
Last year you said was the first